Now, on a completely different matter, on Saturday, the world of sports once again revolved around my hometown of Louisville for the 146th Kentucky Derby. Like so many other events, the coronavirus made this year's Derby look a little different. The race had already been postponed for only the second time in history, and none of the 150,000 spectators who normally fill Churchill Downs were there to sing "My Old Kentucky Home." But the most exciting 2 minutes in sports refused to be defeated. The Derby remains the longest continuously held American sporting event, and this year's Labor Day Derby proved worth the wait. The winning Thoroughbred, Authentic, outlasted a ferocious challenge from the favorite. So I'd like to extend the Senate's congratulations to the entire Hall of Fame team. This year's Derby showed our great traditions can adapt to overcome any challenge, but our sport must be protected. I've been proud to stand up for Kentucky horse racing throughout my career. I introduced a checkoff bill to promote the sport domestically. I assembled a coalition to open new markets in Japan and Hong Kong. I worked to make sure internet regulation did not unduly restrict the racing industry. I've secured tax provisions to promote equine equity and grow investment in Kentucky. It's been my privilege to deliver for this sport and Kentuckians who stand behind it. Today, I'm introducing new legislation to keep it up, because unfortunately, the coronavirus isn't Thoroughbred racing's only challenge. In recent years, tragedies on the track, medication scandals, and an inconsistent patchwork of regulations have cast clouds over the future. The National Publications Editorial Board even called for this sport to be abolished altogether. We needed action to protect the sport we love, defend our history, and the 24,000 Kentuckians who work in the Thoroughbred racing industry. So in Lexington, the horse capital of the world, I announced with my friend Congressman Andy Barr that we'd found a way forward. Today, I'll introduce the Horseracing Integrity and Safety Act to recognize a uniform national standard for thoroughbred racing. Baseball, football, and other professional sports have a central regulatory authority. Thoroughbred racing should as well. Some of the biggest names in the sport, Churchill Downs, Keeneland, the Breeders' Cup, and the Jockey Club, just to name a few, are supporting our plan to provide federal recognition and enforcement power to an independent horse racing integrity and safety authority. The board will be made up of both industry-selected and independent members. It will set national standards for track safety, anti-doping, and medication practices, and lab protocols. This will make thoroughbred racing as fair and as safe as possible. I'm proud to partner with Senator Kirsten Gillibrand on this bipartisan legislation. New York is home to another leg of the Triple Crown. Their junior senator has previously introduced similar legislation to protect our sport. I'm also glad to have the senior senator from California as an original co-sponsor on this bipartisan bill. Today, Congressman Barr and Congressman Tonko will present this legislation over in the House. I'm grateful for Congressman Barr's years of leadership on this issue, and I'm glad we're making bipartisan, bicameral progress with our bill. This way, when we can all return to the grandstands to watch the thoroughbreds round the final turn toward a thundering finish, we'll be taking pride in a fair and safe race.